Hello everybody, it's me again, Asha Markel, Lemon Creation, and I would like to welcome you to our Industrial Steampunk YouTube Hub. You see right now all the fabulous sponsors we have. There are so many of them and they are really great. And in a second you're gonna see all the friends, my arty crafty friends I'm taking the part with in this YouTube Hub. And then there are rules here, but you can also find them in the description box below. So without further ado, let's start. And of course I'm doing a journal page this time. I'm using a Margel from PBO to keep my pages a little bit more sturdy. So I don't have any seepage. You can of course use the gesso for that, but in this case I wanted to do a Margel because I'm gonna be using a rice paper. And so with rice, with the Margel, you can glue the paper very nicely to the surface of the journal. And this journal, I have to tell you, it's super, super fragile. The pages are breaking, so I really need to prepare them well before. And you've seen it, this is very industrial rice paper from Stamperia. I absolutely love it. This is my new buy. And that's the first time I'm using it, of course. And as you can see, to take the bits and pieces from this paper out of the paper, I'm using a wet brush, so like that I can tear the pieces very nicely without any problem. And some parts of this video are sped up, but believe me, you won't lose anything from the technical point of view, because I only speed up the parts which are repetitive. And as you can see, I'm again adding a tiny bit of Margel because there was not enough, or it just dried too quickly. And with rice paper you can do it, you can put it on both sides without any problems. Anyway, with Margel you can put it also on the photos, for example, to preserve them better. So there is no problem at all with that. And I love this, how do you call it, blueprint. It's, I think it's a submarine blueprint. And I wanted to add it there, just in the middle, to also make my pages a little bit stronger, especially in the middle part. Next step is to, of course, dry everything very well. And then I'm gonna be adding some stencil. This one is from Stampers Anonymous from Tim Holtz, but I'm not gonna be using any modeling paste. I'm gonna be using two distress oxides, walnut stain and cracked pistachio, and I'm gonna be adding them with a dabber sponge. And I'm adding the two colors together to get a little bit of mixture of the color. And that actually worked super nice. Later I added a little bit of embossing powder and you'll see some of the letters or numbers I got here. They actually got covered with the embossing paste, but not too much. There were still some of them visible. And the technique of dabbing them in two different inks, it gives you this kind of a rainbowy effect, which I absolutely love. This is gonna be my focal point, a picture and a mid-form casting. And now I'm using my homemade anti-static cushion to clean the page a little bit, and another stamp from Tim Holtz or Stamper Anonymous. And with this one I'm using embossing pad and I'm just stamping on the page wherever I find it fit, and then I'm adding a little bit of embossing powder. And the problem I got here is that my embossing pad is good to change, but I like to push my product to the limits. So some of the stamped images, they weren't that clear after applying embossing powder, but I like this kind of a grungy distress look. So for me that works fine. I'm not gonna be losing sleep over that. And as you can see, I put it more or less on all of the page, or anyway in my in the part of the page when I was working. And then I'm removing the excess, of course, putting it back into the jar, and drying well. And as always, I strongly advise you to use the low heat setting at the beginning, so like that your powder will not fly away, and the excess of the powder I was removing also with a brush, with a dry brush. Now a little bit more of stamping with again fossilized amber distress oxide, and I'm gonna add also a cracked pistachio at the end to add a little blobs of color. If it comes to adding more color, I'm using Lindy's Moonshadow and Starburst, Bayou Boogie Gold and Landlubber Green. And because the page is already, in my opinion, it has enough, maybe not enough, but it has a lot of colors, I'm not really putting too much effort into adding these two beautiful colors. I'm sprinkling them or spraying them on the page, then moving them around with a wet brush, and the second one I'm gonna move it with a wet brush also. The second color, it's one of my favorite, it's Moonshadow, so it has it's brown, but it has very nice green and shiny tint to it. So you're gonna see that exactly when I'm drying, you're gonna see the nice green shiny splotches, which look just perfect on this page. This is a really cool book from Studio Light with industrial paper elements, which are already pre-cut, and I am, as you can see, trying to build my scene, but I didn't glue anything. It's just I prefer to work off the camera, because it kind of sometimes camera stresses me, to be honest. So I like to just kind of get it in my head what I would like to do, check if that makes sense, and then glue all the bits and pieces together. For some of the elements, I wanted to add more interest, so I made small holes through them and I added brads. But because there are metal parts, I cannot really use my matte gel. The advisable glue for that would be a 3D matte gel. So that's what I'm using. Because just simply of these metal parts, which are not gonna stuck into place if you use normal glue or even matte gel. And as you can see, I'm just building my page. I'm adding a little bit of chipboards with numbers, and also another cock from Midform Castings. And since the theme of our hop is industrial, I stayed with another paper element from Studio Light, Work. And this is gonna be my sentiment for this page. And I'm placing it with a 3D foam tape. So like that, I have also a little bit more layers. And the final touch would be to distress a little the edges of the page with the walnut stain distress oxide. And well, that's it. It's a very easy page, isn't it? Not too many layers, not too much stenciling, but I really like the effect. I hope you do. And I hope you will watch all of our videos. I know there is few, but there are nice, really beautiful prizes to win. And as always, thank you so much for watching, for subscribing, for sharing this video. Please don't forget to hit the notification button so like that you can get notified about my upcoming videos. And I wish you all a really, really beautiful day. See you. Bye-bye.